What's up, everybody? Richard and Adam, True Shot, back today with another reaction video. And today we have a merch purchase request from Tyler Bittner. Now, Tyler's a big fan of this band, so he wanted us to check them out. And I told him, like, we have checked some of them out, but I haven't really got too deep into their discography. This is Upon a Burning Body and their track, The Outcast.
All right.
Let's get into it.
I don't know if I've heard this one. Cassette tape.
Might have to turn it up again.
I already did.
Stop. I like that. This one's for the brashing, the bawling, the ones like me. To the divergent, the outcast, I want you to scream with me.
Ooh. Dude, that verse is so heavy.
Nice slow there.
Yeah, dude, the hits are big.
Kill switchy this
Oh yeah. Is he playing a Kiesel?
Goosebumps, holy
dude,
shit.
Good, dude.
Jesus. It's gonna be a hot outro. Boom. I knew that was coming. I love that.
Damn,
man. All right, so that was Upon a Burning Body, The Outcast. Okay. All right, Tyler Bittner with the merch purchase request.
Damn.
Man, I'm intrigued because I know these guys are kind of, they kind of have like that party metalcore kind of vibe, but with a lot of their other music, I know that's kind of what they're known for. They're kind of known for in that ilk of Attila kind of, and I kind of actually kind of felt that with their tones, like guitar tones kind of reminded me of Attila.
Yeah.
But I'll shut up now. I want to hear what your thought.
These guys are hit and miss for me. This was definitely a hit. think I've ever heard a song with a chorus that good from them.
No, yeah. Not that I've listened to much, but yeah.
Same. I mean, I remember...
You've seen them live here.
I have seen them live a couple of times. They weren't bad live either. They hit hard. I mean, they were good. But again, like you said, they kind of fit in that genre that you were kind of talking about.
Yeah.
They did have a classic metalcore sound in that song. Definitely had the recipe there. The hook and the chorus was amazing. Those notes in the chorus I loved, obviously. They were super catchy. The verses were super heavy, but I gave it an 8.5 overall. Just for structure, I thought it was pretty standard. And I guess just kind of knowing them overall, that's a high score that I would give these guys, because I'm just not overall into their overall sound. But this song was, I think, the best one that I've heard from them, personally.
Yeah, I mean, so for me, the thing in the beginning, that
I don't know if it was a bend.
Yeah, I really liked that.
Or like a, you know, he's, you know, like maybe a foot whammy. Switch or something like that.
It was very groovy. That first verse really hit hard. Like I said, the guitar tones kind of really reminded me of
Attila.
Yeah, like kind of like what's the name of that album? Oh man, what is the name of that album? It's like their most popular album with "Party with the Devil." You know, all those. I can't remember the name of that album.
Motley Crue.
What? No, talk about Attila. Wow.
I thought you said "Party with the Devil."
No, remember the song? Remember, because when we
call me old, that's why I said Motley Crue, dude. Jesus Christ! You don't pick it up.
So
you're not picking up what I'm putting down.
What was the name? About That Life. It was kind of had the similar tones to that album, which I do like that. That chorus, I don't know what it was, because I just wasn't expecting a chorus.
No, I wasn't expecting that at all.
And that was just, that was a phenomenal chorus. He had a great vocal, great tone. I loved it, man. The flow was sick.
What'd you give?
The solo was, I just have nothing bad to say. It gets a 10.
What?
Dude, that song was
Listen, 10s are reserved for what we heard tonight.
What was wrong with it?
Nothing was wrong with it, but a 10 is... We gave our first 10s away today.
To me, it
wasn't... 10, you gotta have something extra special. This was, even for the time...
Cookie cutter metalcore. I have nothing to say, like bad to say though. Like,
I just don't agree. I don't agree with your assessment.
That's fine, but I just loved it.
I think it's a great song.
I don't think it's.
I mean, 10. I mean, that's
well. Because okay, I'm sitting here thinking. I'm like, okay, what can I say that would take points? I loved everything.
I don't know. I just don't agree. I don't share your sentiment.
All right. Well,
you're wrong.
You have it.
You're wrong.
There you have it. Adam with an 8.5. Sounds like, I mean, listen.
Rich is just throwing out friggin' 10s now for...
I'm not throwing 10s out for anything, but, I mean, I have nothing bad to say, so I'm not going to sit there and be like, oh, it's a 9.5 just because it shouldn't get a 10. I mean, if I can't reasonably come up with anything that, like, would lower the grade, I don't know. I love those kind of those verses. They hit hard. The chorus was sick. The solo.
You don't have to justify it to me.
I'm just saying, man.
You just have to justify it to them.
All right. Anyways, as you can see all around us, we have all of our usernames to all of our social media, as well as our Patreon and our Twitch. Tyler, thank you for the request, man. That was probably the best merch purchase request I've ever heard. I mean, that was...
Really?
Oh, yeah.
You're throwing around, like,
top-notch stuff today, man. These people out here. Let me tell you something, people. You're throwing out Pangea. It's like a 9-10-minute song. What is wrong with you? This song was short, sweet, to the point, angelic choruses, an awesome solo, a nice kill switch spoken word part, groove in the verses. Wow.
I digress.
As you can see all around us, Patreon, Twitch, username, all of our social media.
To the next one.
Peace.
Peace.